am Miss Kristen.
I'm Miss Kate.
Come along and join us for
Christ Kids TV.
Hey everybody, welcome to Christ Kids TV. You know, it is such a beautiful day that I thought I would take a break from work and come sit outside. I am so thankful for a beautiful, warm, sunny day where we get to enjoy God's creation. And that calls for a prayer. So everybody fold your hands and bow your heads. Dear God, thank you for the gift of a beautiful sunny day. Help us remember to always appreciate your wonderful creation and take good care of it. And all God's children said, amen. All right, friends, have a good day.
To think about the goodness of the Lord. He gives me everything I need and so much more. So I just want to lift my hands and say that I love Him. I just want to lift my heart in praise. And I want to be faithful. I want to be faithful. I want to remember everything that the Lord has done. I want to be thankful. I want to be grateful. I want to be, I want to be, I want to be. I like to think about the goodness of the Lord. He gives me everything I need and so much more. So I just want to lift my hands and say that
our memory verse comes from Psalm 107, verse 1. Give thanks.
Give thanks.
To the Lord.
To the Lord.
His faithful love.
His faithful love.
Endures forever.
Endures forever. Bye.
Pastor time.
Pastor time.
No, just a second. No, I can't tomorrow. Can we check on Thursday? Would that, it's not good for, actually I gotta film Christ Kids TV. Can I call you back? I promise. Yes. Goodbye. Have you ever had a day like this before? I've got two computers working up. My calendar is filled. I'm going crazy. I can't get it all done. Have you ever had a day like that in which you're just so frazzled that you're not sure how you... I gotta calm down. Maybe have some more coffee. Wait, that's not gonna work. I'll put this away. Maybe, I know, I've got this candle here. It's supposed to be a relaxation candle. Let me just put a candle on. And maybe I'll just, breathe the fumes and that's not working. It's not working. Oh, this always works. This always works. Some extra candy from Halloween. Do you have any left over? Oh, maybe that will help. You know, that's not helping. There's times in which you just have to settle down. You have to turn off the computers, put away the phone, maybe even blow out the candle. You know what I find best to do? Put on these. These help. You know what these are? Besides silly glasses, these are my gratitude glasses. You know how they work? The gratitude glasses, I put these on, and now I can see things differently. I can see how God has blessed me. I can count my blessings. I see through these glasses, and I realize that God has given me a food to eat, a home to live in, family to love, a church to work at, kids at Christ Kids TV to speak to. There's a lot of things to give thanks for. And actually, you don't need those silly glasses. Every day you can have a heart of gratitude. Every day you can stop and think about all the great things that God has put into your life. Everything that you say, thank you, God, for this. Now, stop for a second. I'll let you just yell it out loud right here. What are some things that you're thankful for? What is it? Do you have a pet? Do you have a good school? Do you have friends? What else? Yell it out right now. Yell it out. Because when we count all of those blessings, we can return to Jesus and say, thank you, Jesus. I still have a lot to do, but I do it with a calm heart, a thankful heart, a heart full of gratitude for all the blessings that you've given me today and tomorrow and for all eternity. So I'm going to relax. I'm going to enjoy the rest of the day. I still have to go to work. Still have to do a sermon on Sunday. But you know what? I'm going to do it with a heart of gratitude. And so can you. Count your blessings, friends, and return to God to say thank you. Thanks for joining us here on Christ Kids TV.
Hang on, I gotta go put this away. I'll be right back.
still got some more stuff to do. Oh, gracious. Okay. I gotta set these over here. Hang on. Okay. All right. Oh, and now I gotta do some cleaning. So hold on. I'll be there in a second. Oh, goodness. I got so much stuff I gotta get done. I am so worried I'm not gonna be able to make it happen. I mean, I saw Pastor Scott, and he was freaking out because he had so much to do. Oh, my gracious. What do I do? Why? I'm so worried, and I don't want to be worried because, oh, there's got to be a better way than to be worried all the time. Maybe I should try these cool glasses that Pastor Scott had on and see if I can figure out another way to feel besides worried. All right. I'm starting to get it. Let's watch this video together and see if we can learn more about how to not worry.
This is thankful. Don't worry. This is Jesus.
Heyo!
Who is the Son of God and the Savior of the world. Jesus did many amazing things. He taught everyone about God's love, healed people from their sickness, and even calmed storms. One day, Jesus was speaking to thousands of people.
Jesus!
When someone asked him about money, he told them a story and tried to explain to the people that our treasure is not on earth, but in heaven. Then he turned to one of his disciples and said, "That is why I tell you not to worry about everyday life, whether you have enough food to eat or enough clothes to wear. For life is more than food, and your body more than clothing."
Yes.
Look at the ravens. They don't plant or harvest or store food in barns, because God feeds them. And you are far more valuable to God than any birds.
I think so.
Do you think that by worrying about anything, you can add a single moment to your life? And if worry can't do a little thing like that, what's the use of worrying over bigger things?
That's a good point.
Look at all the lilies and how they grow. They don't work or make their clothing. Yet Solomon, the great king of Israel, in all his glory, was not dressed as beautifully as they are. And if God cares so wonderfully for flowers that are here today and thrown away tomorrow, he will certainly care for you. And don't worry about what to eat or what to drink.
Okay.
Many people worry about these things, but God already knows what you need. Seek the kingdom of God above all else, and he will give you everything you need. So don't be afraid, for it makes God happy to take care of you and give you his kingdom. So share what you have with others and give to those who need.
Here you go.
Thank you.
Sure, eh? Hi.
Then you'll be storing up treasure in heaven. And when your treasure is in heaven, it's gonna be safe. No thief can steal it.
Whatever.
And no bug can destroy it.
Man, whatever.
Wherever your treasure is, there your heart will be also.
Wow. It's so much easier to not worry because I know that God loves me and will take care of my needs. We are so lucky to have a God who takes care of us like that. I have so many things to be thankful for. I couldn't possibly name them all. And I bet you can't either. So you know what? The next time I start to get all freaking out because I don't know what I'm gonna do or how I'm gonna get it all done, I'm gonna remember to look through gratitude glasses and always be thankful for so many wonderful blessings. All right, friends, remember, if you're getting worried, see if you can adjust your eyes to look through glasses of gratitude. And I'll see you next time. Bye.
Thanks for joining us this week on Christ Kids TV.